Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. And today in this video I'm going to show you this comp script breakdown what we did recently for this short film called Enigma. So as you can see, this is the final look for this comp, and this is inspired by the Blade Runner. Obviously you can see this similar hazing and the neon lighting and all that glow stuff. I will quickly show you the plate so you can get the idea what we did. This is the actual plate for this shot, and we did this set extension in the background. As you can see, this is exactly what we're going to see, how we did this set extension. We removed this part and we did extension from there, and we also did some changes here. As you can see here, this part we replaced some this light, and we added this neon light, and here we added some props here also. We will going to see this script. As you can see, this is the full script here. Okay, so let's go one by one and see how we form this entire scene from this plate to this final comp. So let's go on the top first. So in the top you can see we have this sky setup here. So this is normal HDRI, and we did this color grading just for the background purpose. In the left side we have this Matchmo camera. Obviously, of course, yes, we have this Matchmo camera. We are using this Matchmo camera here. I will show you where we use this one. And the first layer is the BG city. So this is the BG layer we have. You barely see in the output. I will show you. So these are the lights you are seeing. This is coming from this BG layer. So I will show you. So this is the render we have, and this is coming from Blender itself. This entire CG render is coming from the Blender. So we will see everything. So we have the city layer, and we did basic CG. So we are doing CG rebuild, all these things, and we are merging here, and we get this nice lighting. And this is the precom we have here. So if I show you the precom, so this is the lights we have for the background, and this is going directly on top of this sky setup. So now this is the sky setup, and we also have some additional layer. So we are merging here. So if I show you, in the layer, we have this emission pass. This is just for this lights purpose. I will show you where we are using. So if I view it here, we have this emit pass. So this is basically like a city lights, as you can see now. So we are using here. So we are just passing the passes from this main pipe. So in the downstream, we are using them to add a glow and for other stuff. So this is the second layer, and now we have this road. So if I view this one, so this is the actual road what we use here. Not everything, just for the small portion. So you will see, so this is the city and this is the road. So this is the render for this road, and here we did this. So all these things are single frame. So this is just normal set extension, and for set extension we are using 3D renders. You can also use DMPs like Photoshop layers and all that. The idea is same. What we did here, we just render one single frame. So I will show you. See, this is just a one single frame, and then after did the correction, we did the mesh move using this this image plane and the camera. So we have this camera, and then we did this, then we have this movement. So we basically did a mesh move in Nuke, and then we did a precom. So everything you will see is just a single frame, because this shot is static, so that's why. So now as you can see, this is the main extension. So if I view this one, so this is the actual render we got from the Blender. So there are a lot of work we did here. So if I show you one by one, so this is the full CG rebuild and the correction in this area, and here we have this glow and defocus and precomp in this section. So let's see. And we did some different approach for CG rebuild. Instead of using this what we call diffuse color and diffuse indirect and direct lighting, diffuse indirect, specular direct, specular indirect, instead of using those passes, we are in the Blender we did a different passes. We exported the light passes. In this one we call it the multilight 0, and in this one this is multilight 1. So we have different lights in this different areas what we actually use it in the Blender. So you can see here also, so this is the inside lights, it's looking very good. And similarly this side also we have many lights, you can see now. So different lights, and then we combine them one by one. So did some correction, and we basically just plusing every light, doing the corrections and all one by one. They are merging depending on the look, and here we are also copying this emit light, because if I show you, So this is the emit light for this one, and before we have this emit light, if I view it here, and we are basically just merging them all together. See, now we can see the emit light on top of this one. So that's why we are using this one. After this copying this emit light, now we are again plusing all those remaining layers, as you can see, and then copying the original alpha, we did more corrections on this one. Again, we did a black match here also, and then we are doing a pre-melt all, so we get this lifted look what we need in the final look. So this is necessary. And then we did a channel remove, and then we did a slightly expand glow. Now you can see where it's applying. And after this one, after doing expand glow in this separate pipe, we did a lot of glow corrections. If I show you, so this is the entire glow setup for all those small layers. If I connect this one light here, so if I show you, so these small parts you can see now, they all are having a separate glows and everything. And in the end, we are all merging them together. Then on top of this one, we are doing a plus. So now we have this nice glow based on the look. And then we did a convolve. So I mean, we are basically doing a defocus. So this is just a normal defocus. And this is this tool is coming from this Nuke Survival Toolkit. It just have this inside. You can see we just have this ZD focus, nothing special. And then, as I said, this is a single frame. We did a match move here, so it's like a DMP patch. We are doing a match move in the Nuke, and we are doing a pre-comp here. Now we have this moving part. I don't know why this glitch happened, but I will show you just one frame. So this is a pre-comp here, and again, before it's like this, and then we are merging this one. So the basic idea is comp from background to foreground. Like before, we have this sky layer, then we have the city layer, then we have this road, and then we have this one. So based on the depth, you have to merge it all together. And let's see the plate. So now we have come here. Let's see the plate. Now we have a plate in between. So this is the actual plate we have. So we have to remove this entire section, and we have to replace that city, so it will go properly in a depth like this. So, and again, we have this patch here. So we basically remove these lights and we key mix it from here to here. So this is just a key mix here. Again, for this car, we need to add some lights here, so volumetric rays. So this is exactly what we did. You can see now, very subtle. So this is required for this shot. And again, we are just copying the alpha. So this is the alpha, because here we are replacing this city area, so we need to remove this thing. So we add alpha, and then we did a pre-mult. So we have this now. And again, this optimization, adding a crop, and we have this background. Then we are directly merging here. Now you can see how this comp is building. So we have this, and after that we added a little bit of light trap in the edges. Obviously we have this light, so it should bleed. Added a little bit. You can see now everything is blending here and here, but it's not perfect. In the downstream, you will see more stuff is coming. So now we have this asset. So all these assets, you can see how much we added this AC and this neon sign here and here, and all more ACs. So all these things are we comp in this file. So again, the same setup, just CG rebuild and doing correction one by one and merging all layers together. So again, here also we have this multi-light setup, multi-light 0, multi-light 1. You can see how they are look like. So different lighting, what we added in the Blender file. So we have all those lights here. You can see we just combined and did a copy and then unpremult, and doing a lot of corrections here. Just seeing all those blacks separately and adding a exponential glow again, and doing the same setup here. We have the same setup what we did in the above. We have this glow setup here separately, and then we are just plusing the glow setup on top. When we see here, we have this. So we have this glow setup here, and we have this comp setup here. So in the end, we are getting this one. And again, I am doing the same thing. See, now in this one, we are projecting this part using scanline render. This is exactly what we did here. We just projected, and now we have this animated sign in this entire frame range. Okay, so again, before, let's see the before one. Before, we have the city, and then we added its signs and boards on top. So as you can see, so these are all those props we added. So here and in the above section and in the far one, you can easily see. So currently they are not blending properly. So that is what we did in this next step. So the haze is covering all those imperfection, all those mistakes. Now this shot is very haze intensive. you can see we have a lot of haze and it's blending everything together very nicely. So let's see. So as you can see, as I said, we are using this channel. So this again emit channel, what we created in the above, we are using this one, doing a blur and doing some correction. So, and we have this this fog pass, we are using this one. So this is just a static one, and actually it's an animated one, but for this tutorial I just keep it one frame. Did a corrections here and color and all that, and we also did a chronos just to retime it properly. And again here what we did, we just blur this one and we did a multiply, so we get a color here and then we did a plus. So you can see we have this properly nice color in this element. If I go down, so this is the fog, this is the actual fog color and the fog we have. Now we have to make a depth pass, so we get properly haze in a depth. For that, this entire section is. So let's go above and see what we did. So again, we are using this mist pass and it's coming from the blender itself. And we are using this PRAM to get to remap this value. So by default, this is the mist we have. So we just expanding and get making it normalize. So we get this in alpha, then we grade it according to the shot. In this pipe we are just making a proper depth map, and that's why we did a lot of correction. You can see there are a lot of corrections in the roto section, which I don't know, it's empty for some reason, but somewhere we actually use it. So you can see in here we did actually changes here, you can see now. So these are the small changes we did, and making the depth pass customizable, and where we want more haze based on the depth map, we just adjusted this depth map accordingly. So you can see if I show from here to here, you can see this much is changed. And we also use some geo, we have some geo for this shot. If I show you, so these are the walls, and I think we also have a car. As you can see now, we have this proper car for this shot. See these two things, and we are using them to do a proper holdout. So you can see now, so we just did some additional changes, and that's how we did this. You can see now, so we did some holdout and all that stuff. So in the final, this is the depth map we have, and what we did, we just use this one and did a multiply, invert this one and just making zero. If you don't, then you have this inverted haze. So we want this, so make it zero, and again remove your all channels, and again doing a match move here, just projecting this entire thing on a card. So because this is a very static camera, X and Y movement, you don't need to that much worry about the Z space. So we just align it like this and we render it, then we did a precom. So this is exactly what we have here. Yeah, so you can see from here to here we have this this look, and in the end we added a multiply and we reduced the amount, and then we basically merge this haze. So you can see it's more, we just reduce it how much we want. So you can see of this one how much difference it makes. So the hazing is basically hiding everything, and this is the exactly the look he want. And after that we did convolve, and using this depth map again, so just blurring this far one, defocusing using a kernel. So this is the kernel we have, and we are doing this AP vignette, just adding a little bit of vignetting in the edges, as you can see now. And we have this node called virtual lens, so we just adding this small lens imperfection in this edges. If I can show you, so this and it's called astigmat, so I don't know how to pronounce properly. So it's basically like doing this blur, motion blur kind of things, and we are adding this one only on the edges. This is the alpha, so it's very subtle. We are just adding on the edges, we can see now it's very subtle effect. And then in the end we have this ident plate, and we are basically doing a regrain. Now if I zoom in, you will see the grain we have in this shot. It's very subtle, I guess, but it's get the job done what we actually needed in this shot. And then in the end just adding a crop and everything, and this is the final output you are seeing here. So you can see, so this is the final output and this is the actual shot. So the basic idea is getting doing a set extension just to a proper camera tag, check your perspective. I mean, in this one you can see these are the perspective lines are going in this direction. So the based on that we did a modeling, and we are matching the perspective lines and all that stuff, and we are just rendering one single frame and doing an entire look dev in a Nuke. We just get a base render from the, so this is just a base render we are getting from the Blender. Everything look dev and everything is we are doing in a Nuke, so we have a more control over it. We just getting a proper base shape from the Blender, and then we are just comping and doing our set extension shot. So if you don't have a CG render for the set extension, you can always use Photoshop layers and you can do the same thing what we did here. So you just need to add your, you need to add your Photoshop layer here, and you have to do comp accordingly where the light you need to do, and do a match move in the end and just merge with your main pipe, and that's how you can do your set extension. As you can see, this script is very clean and very very optimized for this shot. This is not a big shot, it's very small shot to do, but we are trying to optimize it and make it clean script so everyone can understand easily. If someone is open the script, he can understand where the B pipe is and how everything is merging. You can see we have just one merge and we are merging all layers one by one, so you can easily understand what we did here. This is the main idea for this shot. I hope you like it, and let me know in the comment what do you want to see in the next tutorial, and I will try to make this possible. This is just a set extension comp what we did recently in this short film called Enigma. I will put the link for this movie, so you can go and watch that trailer/teaser. So thank you for watching, and we will see you in a very next one. Have a great day.